Welcome to part one of the Atlas Copco STanalyzer tutorial series. In this video, we will be going over how to assemble your STanalyzer or STa6000 for the first time when you receive it. As you see here, we have our STa6000, however the instructions for the STanalyzer are practically identical. To begin, let's gather all of our parts. First we have our STa6000, along with the hardware and Torx wrench that come in the box. Next we have our rechargeable lithium-ion battery pack, an STa6000 QC RBU, along with a set of nuts and screws, and some more accessories. Before we get the battery into the unit and power it on, let's install an RBU, or rapid backup unit. This memory chip will define which functions are active on your analyzer, and provide a backup for all your test programs. By removing this RBU from your analyzer and installing it in another, you can get an exact copy of your original analyzer. Before you handle your RBU, it's important that you discharge yourself by touching a large metallic object, and be sure to only lift the RBU from its plastic sides, and not touch the electrical contacts. Step 1 is to remove the Torx wrench from the plastic bag that came with your analyzer. Flip over your analyzer and use the wrench to loosen the two Torx screws on the back plate. Once finished, pull up the cover and place it to the side. You will notice that your RBU came with both screws and nuts. If you are working with an STanalyzer, then your unit will have screw posts already installed in the unit, and you will only need to use the nuts to secure the RBU in place. For the STa6000, it is the opposite, and we will have to use the screws instead since the nuts are embedded into the unit. When you examine your RBU, you will notice that it has two plastic tabs extruding from its base. These tabs must line up with the slots on the PCB in order for the RBU to sit flush. As you can see, this RBU will only fit into the top right slot, and only in one orientation. The other two slots below are for an IRCB or IRCW radio module, which allows for wireless communication through Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. The top left position, which has the window, is where you install the barcode module. Carefully line up your RBU and place it down on the electrical contacts. Do not press down on the RBU, it will not click into position. For the STanalyzer, you will have to thread the screw post through the holes. Once you are confident the RBU is sitting flush, drop the screws through the top holes so that they rest in the nuts below. Then, gently tighten both screws with your fingers until they are lightly snug. Do not over-tighten these screws. You only need to hold the RBU in place so the electrical contacts touch. Install any other modules you have purchased, then replace the back cover and tighten the Torx screws down. Careful not to over-tighten them and damage the plastic. Let's install the battery now. On the lower back plate, there are two tabs with arrows pointing outwards. Simultaneously pull both tabs outwards, and the plate should unlock and pop up. The tabs are tricky to pull apart if you use the pads of your fingers. I use my nails to get a grip on them. Once the lid is popped, gently lift up while pulling towards the tabs to remove it and place it to the side. Check to make sure your rechargeable battery has its electric contacts facing the right direction. Then repeat the process of removing the battery in reverse by sliding the battery into the grooves and firmly pressing down until the tabs click back into place. Now it's time to test the unit. Flip it back over and depress the right arrow which says on. The screen should light up and now display the correct RBU information. If you have installed a radio module, they will also display on screen. You have now successfully installed the RBU and rechargeable battery onto your STanalyzer or STa6000. If you have purchased the protective rubber boot, you can now slide your analyzer into it from the large hole at the top. It takes some force and a bit of pulling to get it through, but it's the only way to get the boot on. Afterwards, you can install the optional kickstand by removing the Torx screws, lining up the kickstand holes over those holes, and screwing it down using the longer Torx screws which were included with your unit. This concludes our tutorial on the initial setup of your new STa6000 or STa analyzer. If you have any questions or comments on your STanalyzer, please leave a comment down below, and we will be sure to include it in our next tutorial series. If you are having problems setting up tests and PSETs on your STanalyzer, check out part 2 of the series, which shows basic functions and the setup of your unit. Thank you for watching, and be sure to subscribe for more updates and video tutorials from Flexible Assembly.